Hi guys, welcome to my channel. I am Asad Ali and today in this video I'll tell you how you can run Scrapy spiders on your Jupyter notebook. If you have not subscribed my channel yet, please do and also like the video as well. Alright, so let's move on. Let me launch my Jupyter notebook. The simplest way is to go to your terminal and type Jupyter notebook. If you have Jupyter notebook installed, it is going to launch, and if you have not installed, you can watch my videos, but simply you can do pip install Jupyter notebook and I think it should Jupyter and it will install. Alright, so let's go to my desktop and try to create a new notebook. First, let me go to my Scrapy tutorials and hold on. Yeah, this is the one. Okay, let me create a new notebook. Alright, so now that let's select a kernel. I think I have Python 3 by default, which is fine. Alright, so let's try to import Scrapy and see if Scrapy is installed or not. Let's import Scrapy and click this thing. That's good, Scrapy is installed. Let's move on to creating our first spider. So let's do that. Let me just create a class first. My spider. And here I'm going to import Scrapy dot. Okay. Alright, so now that we have created the class, let's move on to naming it. Name equals to, let's call it MySpider. Alright, let's now next thing is the domain, allowed domains. So this part is responsible for making sure that Scraper sticks with the website that we want to scrape, okay. So probably I'll go to courts.pk, courtsbooks.pk. To scrape. Alright, so let's scrape this website, books.toscrape. Alright, so this is the website I'm going to scrape, so let's use this one. I'll only need the domain, so let's leave the rest, move the rest of it. Now start request, the link that we are going to use. Next stage is creating the method, parse method, self, and this. Now I'm going to let's just get some basic details from here. We will have the image, link, the title, and the price. Let's try to get that. Okay, this is the image container. Okay, image link. We have, I guess, div. This is the image container, and the next thing is /img, which is supposed to be the image, and image has source, so let's get the source. Okay, now let's move on to the price. The next thing is price. Let's use this PN class. Okay, one more thing I forgot. Now here, what I needed to do is that because there are number of books, so I need to loop over it. First, I need to get the container, then I'll be able to. Okay, my bad. Okay, let's get to this class and then loop over it, okay? Alright, so for container in response.xpath, and I have this article, and inside of this is the clause, I guess, RTACL article product clause. Alright, so this is what we need. Next thing is I'm using xpath on this container, so I'll have to change response to this, and that should start with dot, okay. All right, now we have image, and let's move on to the price. One p price to container dot xpath. because we need text, so it's going to get us the p not. So remember that one more thing, if you want to give it a default, let's strip it. The reason I'm doing it is because if I do once we do dot get, it's going to return something. If it is able to look at that element, if it does not, it's going to return none. Okay, but if you pass anything here, it's going to be the default value. I'm going to pass it empty string so that if there is none type and I want to strip it, remove the empty spaces for every value where we have empty spaces, it will strip that. But if there is none type, it's going to raise an error. So I'm going to give a default value here, then I'm going to strip it. Okay, all right, so let's move on to maybe the link. All right, link equals, I'm going to use this one. I think we will need to get let's ref from here, and rest of the stuff will remain. Now let's move on to the title, I guess. Let's see if we can get the title as well. It is H3, so let's stick with this. So, right with it. Here. Okay, so let's get the link. Title. Pardon. Container.xpath. It was H3, right? Yes. H3/A. H3/A/text and dot get. Okay, now let's print. Sorry, you don't need to print. Let's yield image. Sorry. Okay, what I'm going to do is I'm in Windows and MacBook, I'm able to do this by pressing the command key. I think you should try it using control or alt key, like multiple stuff, multiple things. Okay, all right, so let's do this and it. Alright, so what I'm going to do is I'm going to yield this dictionary here, which is image link, price, link, and the title. Okay. Alright, the scraper is ready. The next thing is running the scraper inside a different cell. Let's try to run it so that it is saved in a compiler. Okay. Alright, so let's create. We have this new cell. Let's first I'll need to import something to be able to run this scraper. Okay. So let's import that. Okay, now I'm going to import from Scrapy dot crawler, import crawl process. Okay, now I'm going to create a process where I'm going to create this object. Inside of it, I can pass the settings. Okay, inside settings, you can add any settings that you want, just like a normal Scrapy project. So you will need to pass those settings as a dictionary. Okay, now here I'm going to use feeds. Okay, feeds are supposed to be like dictionary as well, and inside of it let's call it output.csv, and that is also going to be a format that should be the CSV. Okay, so what happened is that first element of this dictionary is feeds, and the feeds is output.csv, and the output.csv's format is csv. Okay, this is the output.csv is basically the file name, and the format csv is basically the csv file. Okay, all right, so now let's crawl our process dot crawl. Okay, process.crawl, and inside of this crawler I'm going to pass this as a spider. Okay, don't forget to add the spider name here. All right. Okay, now I'm going to start the process and let's see what happens. Let's try to run this and let's hope for the best. All right, so if you look here, we have successfully executed our spider, but it did not, probably did not return anything. All right, so let's have a look what happened here. I think we did everything fine. All right, so wait a second, I think I'm ready. There is method that is start request, so I that just anyways. Okay, now that I have loaded this one, and let's try to alright, so as you can see here, we have got all the image links, the price and link and the title. All the things are saved in our CSV file, so let's get back to the CSV file that we created. Let's go to home, and if you look here, we have this CSV file. Let's open it. Alright, so this is the CSV file that it has created. So this is basically how you run your Scrapy crawler in your Jupyter notebook. So if you have any questions, you can ask, and make sure that you subscribe this channel and hit a like button as well. So anyways, have a good day.